guys, in this video let's look at the Redmi Note 6 Pro's camera settings in detail. So basically I'll be covering manual settings, how to use this manual mode effectively to get some really nice looking images. So first of all, as you can see, if you just swipe all the way to the top, you will have this manual mode. Now if you just tap on this arrow mark, you have all the settings. What settings, when to use? So the first setting that you are looking here is the white balance. Now what this white balance is used for? Let's say that the camera is not recognizing the colors properly inside the frame. That's when you are going to use this white balance to basically get the accurate looking colors. Now, as you can see, there are already preset modes available here, such as the incandescent bulb, sunset or sunrise. You have the shade here. And one interesting, very useful feature is the custom white balance. This is always appreciated. Now, custom white balance can give you accurately looking color images. Now as you are seeing, just as I change the number, more the number, the warmer it gets, and lesser the number, the cooler it becomes, as you are seeing. So based on your situation, based on your scene, what you are trying to capture, just set the value properly and then click the image. So you will get accurate looking images. This is where the color balance is used. This is white balance setting here. It goes all the way from 2000 to 8000, which is nice because you have so many options to customize and then get accurate looking colored images. The next one is the focus. Now, as you guys know how this can be used, but still I will show you. Now, a lot of time the camera doesn't actually perform nice focusing operation, especially when you are close. Say that you are capturing leaves or flowers or person's images. Sometimes the focus just keeps hunting. So what you can literally do is to customize this focus, use manual focus. And as you are seeing, there is a first blue dot over here. Now, this is where I have kept. Now you can move as close to the subject as it gets and then click a picture so that it just cannot hunt and you are definitely in assurance that you have got a very sharp looking image. As you can see, there is a nice bokeh behind and you have the sharp looking image right onto the subject. So this is how you can customize. While you are capturing landscape pictures, I would suggest that you leave it to 70-75 number so that you get sharper images across the board. This is how you can customize literally and get proper focused pictures. Very handy feature. The next one is shutter speed. I suggest always use the shutter speed along with the ISO. Let's say that there is a fast movement in the subject and you want to freeze that movement instantly, then you should keep higher the shutter speed. That means 1 by 1000 second, 1 by 500 second, 1 by 250 seconds. And if you just keep on lowering the shutter speed, such as 1 by 8 second, then it just gets blurry. Make sure to hold your hands properly. And this is used in low light conditions, or say you want to fake that waterfall movement, silky waterfall movement, you can always lower the shutter speed. But faster shutter speeds will freeze the movement. And you have to use it along with the ISO. So ISO number all the way goes from 100 to 3200, which is awesome. Let's say you are in a low light situation and what you want to do is increase the ISO number to 2000 or 1600. You can also keep it to 3200, but sometimes it gets noisier. So depending on the colors, depending on the situation where you are in, you have to do it a trial and error method. So that's when you are going to get accurate results. Now let's say you are keeping the ISO to 1600 in low light situation, then you can actually get fast shutter speed, such as 1 by 125 second. Then if you click a picture, the shutter speed will be fast and it will ensure you that the subject is not actually in movement. So there will be no blur shots. If you want sharper images, if you want to freeze the movement, freeze the action, then use faster shutter speed. If you want to bring some movement, bring some motion in the subject, then use slower shutter speed in combination with ISO, obviously. So that's how you are going to use this. Now, one interesting feature I would like to show you is using this flash. So if you want to lit the subject and make rest of the things dark, what you can do is manually turn on this flash, or you can use it as a torch as well. I would suggest you manually turn on this flash. Then what you have to do is tap on the subject where you want to get sharp picture. So this is the subject right now. I'm just using tap and then sliding down like this in order to reduce the exposure value, which is EV value. Just make it little bit dark, and inside this manual setting, keep it to little bit faster shutter speed, such as the 1 by 500 second, and ISO number to lower number, such as 400, 500. Then let's take a picture. Now, as you can see how bright the image gets and how dark the background is. Now you have to again do some trial and error method. So let's decrease the ISO number, let's keep it to 100 and try it one more time, reducing the exposure value again. So if you are changing the ISO value as well as shutter speed, you will not get to change the exposure value. But if you are just keeping it to default, one of the settings, then you will get this exposure value to change. And then let's click a picture. Now as you can see, it's nicely lit, subject is nicely lit, sharp, and the rest of the background is completely dark. So this is how you can utilize the bokeh as well if you have got some lightings behind the scene. So be it capturing leaves, be it capturing flowers, or even person's images, you can pretty much darken the background just like I am showing right now. Let's say I reduce the exposure value, then click a picture. Now as you can see how the subject is lit and the rest of the thing is background blurred and as well as dark. So this is how you can tweak little bit settings and get some really nice looking images from your Xiaomi Redmi Note 6 Pro. If you enjoyed watching this video, hit that like button, share with your friends. I have made several interesting videos about this mobile and various other mobiles in general, mobile photography as well. So do watch that video guys, subscribe to my channel, and see you all in another one. Till then, take care everyone. Bye bye.